Hello, Internet, and welcome back to my Big Damn TV Geek vlog. This week, I want to talk about some of the summer TV I'm really excited about. So let's get right to it. First up, a show that's actually already premiered, AMC's Halt and Catch Fire, which airs Sundays at 10 p.m. This show takes place during the 1980s computer boom. It follows Joe McMillan, who is played by the amazing Lee Pace. He's trying to reverse engineer an IBM computer and use the technology to its full potential. He doesn't think computers are doing anywhere near what they're totally capable of yet. As of the time I'm filming this, only the pilot has aired. I really like the pilot. I think the premise is really intriguing. I think the cast is great. Granted, I might be a little biased because I'm kind of totally in love with Lee Pace. But I just think there's a lot of really great intriguing stuff happening in the pilot and great groundwork set for the rest of the first season, so I highly recommend checking it out. Next up, the only other show on this list that's already premiered, and that's Orange is the New Black Season 2, which is now available on Netflix. I talked quite a bit about how much I adored Season 1 of Orange is the New Black on this vlog over the past year, so I was so excited for Season 2 to finally arrive, and it has not disappointed. As of the time I am filming this, I have watched 6 of the 13 episodes of Season 2, and it has not disappointed. It has continued to be just as terrific as Season 1. The writing, the acting, the story, it's all amazing. They've added a new character that's kind of thrown things in Litchfield into turmoil a little bit, and I'm really enjoying that. They've done some flashbacks for the side characters that they didn't get to in Season 1 that I really, really love. So they're really doing terrific stuff again, and I highly, highly recommend checking out the show if you haven't yet. It is well worth the time. Moving on to shows that haven't premiered yet, first up is FX's The Strain, which premieres July 13th at 10 p.m. This show is kind of a mashup between a viral outbreak and a vampire story. The trailer looks super spooky, and FX has been doing such good, like, dark, intense TV lately with Fargo, for instance, that I'm just so excited, and I think it's going to be amazing. The creative team behind it features Guillermo del Toro of Hellboy and Pacific Rim fame, and Carlton Cuse of Lost and Bates Motel fame, so you know the writing and storytelling is going to be off the charts great. And the cast features Corey Stoll, who is amazing on House of Cards, and Sean Astin, who's been in a zillion things, but is perhaps most popularly known as the one and only Samwise Gamgee from The Lord of the Rings. So there's just a lot of really great elements in this that I think are going to lend themselves to being a really cool horror television show. So I'm very excited. Next up, HBO's The Leftovers, which premieres June 29th at 10 p.m. I think this show has a really fascinating premise. It's based on a book, and some percentage of the human population just vanishes one day, like the rapture. And it deals with the consequences of those left behind, the leftovers. How does humanity keep functioning? What's the emotional fallout? Things like that. So I think there's a lot of really meaty story potential there that could be really great to watch as a television series week to week. It is being run by Damon Lindelof. I know it's kind of an internet rule to hate him because of the way Lost ended, but I'm really excited to see what he does with his next project. I really liked the Lost finale, so I think this could be really great. Plus, it's HBO, and HBO just generally makes really great TV, so I'm willing to give it a shot just because of that. There are also a couple of interesting comedies coming this summer that I'm excited about. The first is FX's Married, which premieres July 17th at 10 p.m. It's always so hard to judge comedy based on a 30-second trailer. You know, as far as I can tell, this is a show about married people and the struggles of being a married couple with kids, but the real hook for this show for me is its cast. It features Judy Greer and Nat Faxon as the leads, and these are both people who I find hilarious, and I'm excited to see them anchor a comedy. Judy Greer has been in a zillion things over the years. She's always hilarious, perhaps most notably as Kitty in Arrested Development, and I love the idea of her being a lead in her own show. Nat Faxon was great in Fox's criminally underloved Ben and Kate a couple years ago, And I just think the idea of the two of them playing off each other as leads in a sitcom is great. So I'm really looking forward to Married. The other comedy I'm really looking forward to is IFC's Garfunkel and Oates, premiering August 7th at 10 p.m. If you don't know Garfunkel and Oates, I don't know how exciting this show is gonna be for you. If you do know Garfunkel and Oates, I don't need to explain why this show is so exciting. Garfunkel and Oates are a musical comedy duo made up of Kate Micucci and Lucky Lindholm. They have all sorts of hilarious music videos all over YouTube. You should go look them up because so funny, totally worth the time. The show, it sounds like, is gonna be looking at the struggles of being a comedy duo in a, you know, vaguely autobiographical but mostly just having fun kind of way. It sounds like they're gonna be bringing on a whole bunch of their comedy pals to guest on the show, so it's gonna be a really, really fun time. And if you're into comedy at all, I'm sure it's gonna be worth watching. I, for one, am super excited and I can't wait. So that is what I am most looking forward to on TV this summer. And can I just say, it's great to have really high quality TV to look forward to in the summer months and not just be a slave to Netflix for 3 months. So great. What are you looking forward to this summer? Did I miss your most anticipated show? Let me know in the comments. As always, please like and share this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to my channel so you can keep on watching my vlog. You can follow me on Twitter at BigDamnTVGeek, and there's a link to my blog in the description. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.